Hey y'all, I just wanted to talk about our dependency as black people. You know what? I'm gonna stop using the term as black because there are a lot of people out here that do not identify as black. I found that in my conversations with some melanated people, that their ancestors was on the first one or two boats, and because that their ancestors did not go through the chattel slavery that our ancestors did, they cannot identify with us. So if you find yourself talking to these people, you are kind of wasting your time because they do not identify as black. No matter how much melanin they have in their skin, they do not identify with us. So with that being said, I just wanted to talk about the dependency that we have with this system that we live in. Our dependency is sick. It really is sick. We have grown so dependent on resources outside of ourselves that we are afraid for the system to crash. We are afraid for what we have known all this time, all of our lives, for it to fail. We have this sense of fear that we don't know what to do. Now, you Christians out there, why are you afraid? Why are you afraid of the system crashing? Because you have Jesus, right? That's what y'all say. You know, I was taught that too. You know, Jesus will save us when the dollar crashes. So why are you afraid? Why are you afraid? And when this system that we live in finally crashes, it has crashed. It has crashed in history before. And they only tell you about how they reacted to it. They don't tell you how we reacted to it. See, they reacted to it by killing themselves, jumping off buildings, not knowing what to do. We reacted by starting our own businesses, hence the Black Wall Street. And when they were jealous that we were able to sustain ourselves without your system, outside of your system, that we can still make it. Because let's face it, we've been here for thousands of years. So we have lived and survived everything, nature, man, disease, famine, everything. We're like cockroaches. For real. We don't die, we multiply. So it is sickening to see melanated people afraid of the dollar crashing when that could be the best thing, the next best thing that could happen to us, because that would allow us to really be forced to fend for ourselves, because we don't want to fend for ourselves now. We want to depend on a system. We want to depend on someone else. We want someone else to take care of us instead of us taking care of ourselves. Okay? You know, I get up and go to work every day. I'm sure a lot of us do. But when they decide that they no longer need your services, you are no longer able to provide for your family. So essentially, you're not providing for your family. Whatever corporation or company that you're working for is providing for your family, not you. Now, it is hard to get out there and start your own business. I have multiple business plans that I would like to get started, but I can't do it because, you know, I'm by myself and I cannot afford to walk away from my full-time job at the plantation. That is what we stand up against. But if the dollar fails, there will be no job to go to. There will be no money to earn. So you will be forced to survive on your own. And melanated people, you all act like you forget how to put a seed in the ground. Did we really forget what our grandmothers taught us? What our grandparents, great grandparents taught us, if you were blessed enough to have those people around to teach you? I mean, they teach you in elementary school before all the fuckery comes in, for real, they teach you in school how to put a seed in the ground. You had to do a science project for that. Put a seed in the ground. You have dogs and cats. We've been raising pit bulls and breeding them. I mean, we should know how to raise cattle, and I mean, it's part of our nature. But because we've been separated from our nature, we've been taught to depend on a system, we have forgotten. And melanated people, we need to get back to that. We need to get back to living from the earth and learning where we truly come from, because that's all we're gonna have very soon. That's all we're gonna have. There's not gonna be any food stamps, any Medicaid or anything. You're gonna need to know what to do when your child gets sick. You're gonna need to know what to do, because there will be no pharmacy to go to. There will be no doctor's office to go to. So what are you gonna do then? Go into a panic? These are things that we need to start figuring out and learning now. Now, while we have the quote unquote freedom to do that, before they start taking all the books off the shelves and blocking your Kindle and changing all the information that's currently out there. And you really won't know what's real and what's not. I mean, like I said again, people, you don't have to agree with what I'm saying. You could criticize me or whatever. I don't care. Because when it goes down, because it's going down, when it goes down, once you finally realize that, that $300 you spent on that pair of Jordans last week, you really should have been spending that on some books to teach yourself how to survive. How to survive what we're getting ready to go through. And it's not just black people and melanated people. It's going to be all people that fit a certain financial status. Because best believe, all the millionaires, they are making a way for themselves. They are building houses and bunkers and condos underneath the ground. They are building and creating water filtration systems and airways underneath the ground so that they can survive. So y'all can keep bullshitting if you want to. I'm just saying.